Today's vote by the member states of UNESCO to admit Palestine as a member is regrettable, premature, and undermines our shared goal of a comprehensive, just, and lasting peace in the Middle East. The United States remains steadfast in its support for the establishment of an independent and sovereign Palestinian state. But such a state can only be realized through direct negotiations between the Israelis and the Palestinians. The United States also remains strongly committed to robust multilateral engagement across the UN system. However, Palestinian membership as a state in UNESCO triggers long-standing legislative restrictions which will compel the United States to refrain from making contributions to UNESCO. U.S. engagement with UNESCO serves a wide range of our national interests on education, science, culture, and communications issues. The United States will maintain its membership in and commitment to UNESCO, and we will consult with Congress to ensure that U.S. interests and influence are preserved.
Does that mean that you have stopped effectively today contributing to UNESCO?
It does.
It does.
We were to have made a $60 million payment to UNESCO in November, and we will not be making that payment.
$60 million?
$60 million.
And that is what, a part of a tranche of the total of 80?
Correct.
All right. So this is not particularly a banner day for U.S. diplomacy. If you count the abstentions, you had 159 countries did not vote the way you did. But only 13 did. That would seem to suggest that these countries don't agree with you that this is such a big, that this is a big problem. Those countries included the France. They included numerous members of the Security Council. What happens to them now that you're punishing UNESCO? What happens to these countries that also that voted to in this regrettable way that is going to undermine the peace process?
Well, those countries obviously made their own national decisions on this vote. We disagree with them. We made clear that we disagree with them before the vote. We make clear that we disagree with them after the vote. We also make clear here today that we want to continue our relationship with UNESCO, but as we said before this vote, and as we have had to say today, legislative restrictions compel us to withhold our funding now, and that will have an impact on UNESCO.
Going back to what you said in your opening, you said that this was is regrettable, premature, and undermines our shared goal. Whose shared goal? Who shares this goal other than the 13 other countries that voted with you? Yeah.
Countries all over the international system share the goal of a Palestinian state in secure borders.
How could they possibly do something that you say is so horrible and detrimental to that process?
Yeah.
How can you still count on them as sharing this goal?
You'll have to speak to them about why they made the decision that they made. We considered that this was, as I said, regrettable, premature, and undermines the prospect of getting where we want to go. And that's what we're concerned about.
Okay, and how does it undermine exactly, how does it undermine the prospect of where you want to go?
The concern is that it creates tensions when all of us should be concerting our efforts to get the parties back to the table.
The only thing it does is it upsets Israel, and it triggers this law that you said that will require you to stop funding UNESCO. Is there anything else? There's nothing that changes on the ground, is there?
Our concern is that this could exacerbate the environment, which we're trying to work through so that the parties will get back to the table.
How exactly does it exacerbate the environment if it changes nothing on the ground, unlike, say, construction of settlements? It changes nothing on the ground. It gives the Palestine membership in UNESCO, which is a body that the U.S. was so unconcerned about for many years that it just wasn't even a member.
Well, I think you know that this administration is committed to UNESCO, rejoined UNESCO,
right,
wants to see UNESCO's work go
forward. Actually, it was the last administration that rejoined UNESCO, not this one. But I need to have some kind of clarity on how this undermines the peace process, other than the fact that it upsets Israel.
Again, we are trying to get both of these parties back to the table. That's what we've been doing all along. That was the basis for the president's speech in May, basis of the diplomacy that the quartet did through the summer, the basis of the statement that the quartet came out with in September. So in that context, we have been trying to improve the relationship between these parties, improve the environment between them, and we are concerned that we exacerbate tensions with this, and it makes it harder to get the parties back to
the
table.
Since the talks broke off last September until today, how many times have they met together with all your effort?
How many times have the parties met?
Yes.
I think you know the answer to that question.
Correct.
It doesn't change the fact that we all are committed to
trying. So how can things get worse than they already are?
Matt, I think you're engaged in a polemic here rather than questions. Saeed, please.